Never before since the inception of the iPad and its initial release to the public has there been an influx of diverse apps targeted to the art community. Today, one search in the App Store for art apps will bring up heavy hitters like Procreate, Medibank Paint, and Adobe Sketch. And many of these apps are feature-rich, allowing you to draw accurately in perspective and even create full comics and graphic novels, all on a device once deemed not good enough for professional work. But with all this growth and diversity, well, sometimes things can get a little bit noisy. Hey guys, what's up? This is Eric Merced, and in this video, I'm going to review a new app by Icon Factory called Linea App, and its goal is to turn down the noise. It would be a bit unfair to compare Linea App to heavy hitters like Medibank Paint or my favorite app, Procreate. And that's because unlike these two apps and any other apps like it, Icon Factory, the developers of Linea App, are not out to give you another fully featured drawing app. Instead, their aim is to cut down on features or heavy UI elements to give you a simplified, natural sketching experience. So what can we compare Linea App to? Two apps come to mind, Apple Notes and Paper by 53. And I won't even mention Adobe Sketch, because unlike Linea App, Adobe Sketch is meant to work side by side with Adobe Photoshop, so it's more of a companion app than anything else. Notes App and Paper are both meant for simple, natural feeling sketching on the iPad. This is why both of these apps don't have layers and have very little tools to work with. But Linea App goes a step further from these two apps in that it does offer layers and a host of other simplified features. Let's take a look at what the app has to offer. Like I said, Linea App does offer layers, but there's a limit of 5 layers. However, you can arrange and rearrange each layer as well as perform common functions such as lowering opacity, hiding, merging, and clearing the contents of any layer. There are little neat UI tricks you can perform too, like double tapping on any layer will automatically hide that layer. And each layer has a tiny toggle on the side that works to lower or raise the opacity without the need of opening up the layers menu. Apart from layers, Linea App also comes with a variety of grids and template choices, including a 4x4 grid, isometric, or dot grids. There are also templates for app designers like iOS app icon templates and phone and tablet screen templates. And finally, there are also templates for storyboarding. Linea App also gives you a choice of 4 different paper backgrounds you can use, from paper grain, butcher's paper, black construction, and blueprint. Linea App cuts down on over-cluttering the user with various tools by limiting itself to 5 different tools. Among them are the technical pencil, classic pencil, felt tip pen, wide marker, and the traditional ever-so-handy eraser. By the way, while there is an actual eraser tool on the tools palette, you can easily erase with your finger, which makes erasing all the better since the Apple Pencil does not have an eraser end like most Wacom Cintiq styluses have. As for the Apple Pencil support, yes, Linea does support the Apple Pencil, and quite honestly, any art app developer that does not feature Apple Pencil support in their apps is just digging their own grave at this point. However, pressure sensitivity is another matter altogether. Pressure sensitivity does work, but in keeping with establishing a more natural, real-life sketching experience, Linea App only really supports it on 2 of the 5 tools, and those are the technical and classic pencils. But pressing down with more pressure doesn't make your lines bigger or thicker. They make them darker, just like it would happen in traditional sketching. And while this may be a deal-breaker for some, I feel that anyone turning away from the app due to this level of pressure sensitivity is missing the point of the app. Linea is not out to give you a simulated drawing experience. Sure, you can pick up a pencil tool in Procreate or Medibank Paint, even in Photoshop, and set it to get bigger and thicker the more pressure you add. But Linea keeps things simple by grounding itself to reality from the get-go. In analog sketching, our pencil lines don't get bigger and or thicker the more we press down. They get darker. Press too hard and they'll break. The upside to using Linea App? We won't break any pencil tips. But just don't go pressing extremely hard on that Apple Pencil, though. But recognizing the need to vary lines sizes, Linea app offers three different stroke sizes per tools, plus two blending choices each for the felt tip marker, the wide marker, and the eraser tool. Erasing with your finger cancels out the additive pigment blending mode in the eraser, but using the Apple Pencil supports it. I would certainly love to see this feature make its way to finger erasing eventually, and if it's at all possible, in future updates. As for colors, Linea app offers a color palette which is nested to the left side of your screen. There are predefined colors in the palette, each with varying hues, which makes color blending a breeze, but you can also create and store your own colors if any of the default colors will not do. Linea app also supports full screen drawing, as well as canvas rotate and undo and redo with two finger tapping to undo and three finger tapping to redo, a feature made famous by Procreate and one I look forward to using in every app I use. Unfortunately, not all apps support this feature, so extra kudos to Icon Factory for recognizing its usefulness and adding it to Linea app. As for the overall UI and user experience, Linea app is as simple as it gets. Consider it a bridge app between bigger heavy hitters like Procreate. So going in and thinking of Linea as an app to do fully finished and polished comics or illustrations would be the wrong way to go about it. However, need to design an icon, or maybe storyboard a scene in that new secret Pixar movie you're working on? Then Linea app is the right tool for you. I've been using the app for a few days now and I'm really enjoying the dead simple natural sketching experience, even more than I have in apps like Adobe Sketch or Paper. The last feature I want to talk about is sharing and exporting. Like most iOS art apps, Linea app supports sharing to a variety of destinations, from saving to your camera roll to opening your sketches or designs in Medibang Paint or Procreate. But Linea app also gives you flexibility while exporting in that you can crop any part of your sketch and export to one of three formats, including PSD support. But it's worth mentioning that as of the first release, cropping your canvas is not supported in PSD exporting. So the final question that we can ask is Linea app an app you could use? For me, while I love working in Procreate to do all of my work, from time to time, I like using stripped-down apps that offer an even more natural sketching experience. Not that I can't get that in Procreate, but because of all of its features, it's harder to not concentrate on them in Procreate. Whereas in Linea app, I can just sketch normally like I would in traditional sketching. No worries about thick, big lines when I press a little more on the pencils, because that's not the way it works with a real pencil. No more fiddling around with brush settings when sketching as I would normally in Procreate, because our real pencils don't come with hidden settings. Linea offers a simplified natural drawing experience, just like Notes app or Paper do, only with a bit more flexibility for when you really need a few layers here and there. Linea app is available now in the iOS App Store. It isn't free, but it's definitely worth it in my opinion. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Any questions or comments? Leave them down in the comments section. And as always, you can show your support by clicking or tapping on that like button. I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, stay creative and create great things. God bless you all.